never been born. I'll tell you the best thing I ever did do. Pull off the old coat and put on the new.
This week, but it's true they wouldn't keep saying it over and over again. I can tell you that we wouldn't lie to you. We're going to do a song for you now. It was written by all five of us. One of the things I love about being in this group is several people really enjoy writing songs. And Wayne wrote that song that you heard first tonight, "Lonesome Pine."
Lonesome Pine.
Just had an attack of puberty there. No problem.
Lonesome Pine, Mr. Douglas. That looks like a plant on
the moon. We're going to do a song, though, that was written by all five of us, and this is about a place up where Sean's grandfather bought a cabin in the 1950s up in a place called the High Knob. We were up there eating deer meat and practicing one weekend, and boy, we had a great time, didn't we, Wayne? We had a wonderful time. I'm telling you what. And we found out a fellow was going to buy 1,200 acres of land up there that day to clear cut all the timber off of it. Sean said, "Look, that's a shame because I've lived here all my life, you know." And so we got inspired to write this song about one person's experience about living what he grew up with, losing what he grew up with. It's called Clear Cut.
Childhood beneath the hardwood trees. Didn't know what I had, then was all I'd ever need. used to grow, but it's gone up there today. Mudslides down the mountain, there's no way to stop the flood. Hills without their timbers, like a man without his blood. Scars upon the land, those ones will never heal. But a green man never gives till.
Taylor here. I might as well introduce everybody. On the bass, Richlands, Virginia. Meg, welcome Mr. Wayne Taylor. Yeah. Oh, over here on the Dome Row is from Millbrae, California, the heart of bluegrass music in the West. That's Mr. Rob Ikes. He had the privilege of playing on two records that won Grammy Awards this past year, so we're real proud of Rob. The banjo, and now has the mandolin. He's from Newland, North Carolina, a town that has how many stoplights?
Two.
All right, how many dogs?
14
dogs this week. And he's a fine fella and a fine musician. His name's Jason Burleson. Over here on the mandolin, usually, and now picking up the fiddle, is one of the finest singers I'm privileged to know. I'm really have known this guy for quite a while because he's from right around, I don't know, 25 miles from where I'm from, but he's
boy, I just can't get this out of my throat.
That's all there is to it, folks. I promised myself I wouldn't do that, but I just kind of slipped that anyway. It's a fella here, he played with Doyle Lawson for a while, and he played with Ricky Skaggs, and give him a nice hand. His name's Sean Lane. Yeah. He probably needs no introduction. He's from Kingsport, Tennessee, another Grammy Award winner. Would you please make welcome on guitar, Mr. Tim Stafford. Well, thank y'all. We're going to do a song now that Wayne and myself and Jason wrote. We were in the studio doing our first record, and Wayne said, "Boys, now if I'm singing out of tune, y'all tell me because I can stand the truth." And we said, "Boy, I can stand the truth. That'd make a great song, Wayne." And we thought about it, and on the way back home, it took about 5 hours to get from Nashville to Kingsport, and we wrote this song. It's called "I Can Stand the Truth."
Thank you. see the proof that our love is all over. Tell me, honey, you know I can stand the truth.
A couple more for you and get on out of here. We really appreciate y'all putting up with us. We're just tickled to death. We played our first show New Year's Eve, and I was telling a bunch of people, you know, for something just started out as a way for me to stay picking. That's basically what it started out as, and I'm just tickled to death with the way it's going. Couldn't be playing with four better guys, and just appreciate all the nice things that have been said about us this week. We really, really, really do appreciate it. I can do a song for you that this is one that's on our record, Long, Long Road, on the Rebel label. And it's about farmers. There's lots of farmers back where I come from. And one day I was back there reading the paper in Greenville, Tennessee, Benny's hometown there. And there was a thing in there about how farmers were having it bad. And I said, well, big deal there. Everybody knows that. But, you know, and they were saying how the sons and daughters were not going into farming. They were leaving in record numbers in that part of it. Part of the state, and it's a bad situation all over. But the farmer's been having a shortage of the deal for a long time now in this country. So I was thinking of that, and thinking of some friends of mine down in Greene County, Tennessee, who are some of the best people in the world, had the worst things happen to them. Y'all know people just like it. So those two circumstances were why I wrote this song. It's one called Farmer's Blues. I swear to God, if I could get any hotter, I don't know if I could or not, but we're going to do one more song for you, and go by the Rebel booth there and talk to Dave and all them people there. Gary, they've just done a wonderful job. Greg Greenstein, and we've also signed up with Mike Drudge of Class Act Entertainment. Really glad to be working with him. The name fits with that boy. I tell you what, he is a class act. And we're going to do one more song for you. That's one on our record, and it's kind of a, I don't know, it's kind of a down song. It's about murder and one of those common bluegrass themes, you know. But it's got that nice, in-your-face kind of nice murder sound, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Sort of that kind of thing. Well, anyway, you know what I mean. This is one that's called In the Gravel Yard. We'll see y'all later.
So they said.